In this video, I'm going to show you how to quickly record your keynote slideshow with all of its builds, animations, and effects, along with a webcam shot using just QuickTime Player for the Mac and Keynote's Play Slideshow in Window feature. This is a quick and easy way to create video presentations and lecture-style learning videos. Let's jump in. All right, I'm going to start things off here in Keynote. I'm using Keynote version 10.3.9. Now, you need Keynote version 10.1 or later in order to follow this tutorial. Okay, so I've got my good old demo project here. I'll quickly play it by going up to the top toolbar and selecting the play button right here. And Keynote goes into full screen mode. I'll hit the forward arrow key to advance through my slideshow, and you can see there are various animations or builds. Now, in order for these animations or builds to play, you have to be in playback mode in Keynote. So I'll just hit escape to get out of playback mode. So I've got this slideshow, and now I want to add my talking head or a video narration to my slideshow using my webcam and to record the whole thing as a video that I can share. So to do that, I'm going to use QuickTime Player. But first, I need to set up a few things. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to the top menu bar here in Keynote and select Play Slideshow in Window. This is the new feature that came out in Keynote 10.1 and is the key to the method I'm showing you. I'll select it. And this window pops up that contains my slideshow. Now with this window active, when I hit the forward arrow key, you see my slideshow plays with all its animations. Now the beauty of this feature is now I can play my Keynote slideshow with all of its effects and animations and still have access to other applications on my Mac, like Zoom, OBS, and QuickTime Player, as you'll see. Now if you want to close this playback window, you just hit the escape key and you're back in the Keynote editing interface. I'm going to go back to the top menu and select play slideshow in window to bring back my slideshow window. Now you can change the size of this playback window by just clicking and dragging on the corners to resize it. Now when I drag out my window to the boundaries of my screen here, you'll see these black bars appear on the sides. Now I've tried changing different settings in Keynote settings and the slide settings, but these bars continue to appear. Seems to be a quirk of the playback window. Now it's not a huge problem. You can just get rid of these bars by simply clicking and dragging and then just center up the playback window on the screen. All right, with my Keynote slideshow window ready to go, I'm next going to set up my webcam shot. And to do that, I'm going to launch QuickTime Player. Now, there's a number of ways you can launch QuickTime Player. You can use the Finder, or you can use the Launchpad, or you can use the keyboard shortcut Command Spacebar to bring up Spotlight Search. And then I'll start typing QuickTime, and you can see QuickTime Player appears. I'll hit Return, and that launches QuickTime Player. Then I'm going to go up to the top menu here in QuickTime Player and select File, New Movie Recording. And up pops my webcam feed. Now, if you're not seeing your webcam, make sure your webcam's plugged in first. And then also go down here to the options setting of the QuickTime Movie Player beside the record button here. If you click this little arrow, you'll get some settings. And under camera, make sure that your camera is selected. In my case, it's the Logitech Brio. Don't worry about microphone because we're not going to be recording audio through the QuickTime Movie Player. And down here in quality, I have it set to high. High records a 720p HD video, which is fine for my purposes. I don't need maximum, which gives me a 1080p and a much bigger file size, because I'm going to be squishing down my QuickTime window into the corner of the screen. 720p or the high setting is fine, so I'll leave that there. And I'll click and drag the corner of my QuickTime movie window to shrink it all the way down. And then I'll click and drag it and place it just down here in the corner of my slideshow. Or I could even place it over this way a bit, but I'll just leave it right there. Okay, so a couple things about this QuickTime Player window that are important. One thing you just saw, if I mouse over this window, you'll see that the title bar of the movie window appears as well as the controls, which is not what you really want to have show in your recording. So while you're giving your presentation or delivering your slideshow, make sure you avoid mousing over this window and having this stuff appear. One other important thing, when you're running your slideshow here in this keynote playback window, you have to make sure that the window is active in order to use it. So if I click on this window to make it active, watch what happens. My QuickTime movie window disappears. That's not gonna work. Well, my QuickTime movie window did not disappear. It's actually sitting underneath of this keynote playback window. So I'll just shrink that down and there's my QuickTime movie window. So to prevent this from happening while you're making your recording, with your QuickTime movie recording window open, go up to the QuickTime menu, the top, and select View, Float on Top. Now, your QuickTime movie window will stay on top of this keynote slideshow playback window. So even when it's active, my QuickTime movie window is still on top. Okay, now I'm ready to record. Now to record this arrangement, I'm gonna use QuickTime Player's screen recording application, Screenshot. So to bring up Screenshot, I'm gonna select my movie window to make QuickTime Player active. Then I'll go up to the top menu here and select File, New Screen Recording. And up pops the screenshot interface down here. Now looking at this interface, I'm gonna make sure first of all that record entire screen is selected because I want to record my entire screen. Then I'm gonna go over to the options window here and I'm gonna click that. And up comes the options window. And in options, at the top, save to, I wanna set that to desktop. Okay, now I wanna go back into options again, so I have to go back down and click it to open it up. And I see the timer is set to 5 seconds, and that's fine, I'll leave it there. You can select no timer or 10 seconds. And then down here in the microphone, now this is very important because this is the microphone that's going to record your voiceover for the screen recording that's gonna go with this entire video. So you wanna make sure you select the microphone that you're gonna use. So in my case, that's the Rode NT USB Mini. Then down here in the options section, I wanna make sure Show Floating Thumbnail is selected. What this does is when I'm finished my recording, a thumbnail of my recording will appear briefly on screen for about 5 seconds that I can click and then I can review my recording or do some editing as I'll show you later. Okay, so with my settings all the way I want them, go down to options to click off of that. And now I'm ready to record. And I can do that either by pressing this record button down here on the screenshot interface, or I can just click on the screen when I see this camera icon. So I'll do that. And I get my 5 second countdown right here. And then I'm recording. And I know I'm recording because of this small little stop button icon on the top menu bar. All right, so now that I'm recording, making sure first of all, my keynote slideshow playback window is active, very important. Make sure this is active. So click it, make it active. And I'm gonna take my mouse off of it so I can lose the title. And then I'm going to just use my backward arrow to go back to the beginning of my presentation here. And now I'm ready to start my presentation slideshow. So I'll just give myself a bit of a pause. Hey, it's Mike. And in this video, I wanna talk about the three phases of video production. The first phase of video production is pre-production. This is when you're doing your planning, you're writing a script or maybe an outline, you're gathering props or researching locations. The third phase of video production is post-production. This is editing, this is sound design, sound mixing, perhaps you're doing graphics. This is where you're packaging together your video project for delivery. And those are the three phases of production. And I do a little pause. And then I can stop my recording by going up to the top menu bar and hitting that little stop button. And up pops this thumbnail of my recording, which I can select to review and edit my recording. Now you have to move quickly because the thumbnail stays on screen for only around 5 seconds. Now if you miss it, you can always find your recording in the Save To location you selected in the screenshot options. So I'm going to select this thumbnail, and up pops the Quick Look interface. So here in the Quick Look interface, I can do a number of things. I can play back my recording by hitting this play button down here. Because of this small little stop button icon, and you can see the beginning of my recording here. Right,
so now that I'm recording, I'm just going to take my mouse.
I'll hit the pause button to stop that. But more importantly, you can actually do some editing in this Quick Look interface. I'm going to go up to the top of the Quick Look interface and select this trimming button right here. And up pops the standard Apple trimming interface with this yellow selection bar around the frames of your video. So what I'm going to do now is trim off the beginning and the end of my recording where I'm preparing to record or stopping my recording. And I can do that by just clicking and dragging on the little handle here on this yellow bounding box. So this will be trimming the beginning of my video. Right about there looks good. Then I'm going to go down to the end, to this right handle here. Click and drag that. Right about there is good. Now I can play back my trimmed area by just going over here and hitting this play button, or I can hit the space bar. Hey, it's Mike, and in this video I want to talk about the three phases of video production. The first phase of video production is pre-production. That looks good. When I'm done my trimming, I can just go up to the top of the interface here and click the Done button. And your trimmed video is saved to the Save To location that you set in the options for screenshot. So in my case, it's the desktop. Here's my final trimmed recording. Hey, it's Mike, and in this video, I want to talk about the three phases of video production. The first phase of video production is pre-production. One piece of advice with this technique: try to keep your screen recordings as short as possible. Screenshot is recording to your Mac's internal drive, so if you don't have a lot of space there, or if you're running a bunch of other applications while you're screen recording, you may run into some unexpected results. If you have a large presentation, try breaking it into shorter sections, and then take those shorter videos and stitch them together using QuickTime Player. I have a tutorial on my channel that shows you how to edit video using just QuickTime Player. Have a look. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.